And first of all, I'd say starting a business is not for everyone. Generally, starting a business, I'd say number one is have a high pain threshold. That's it. There's a friend of mine who's got a good saying, which is that starting a company is like eating glass and staring into the abyss. Okay, that's generally what happens. Because when you first start a company, there's lots of optimism and things are great. And then, so happiness at first is high. Then you encounter all sorts of issues, and happiness will steadily decline. And then you'll go through a whole world of hurt. And then eventually, if you succeed, and in most cases, you will not succeed. And Tesla almost didn't succeed, came very close to failure. Then, if you succeed, then after a long time, you will finally get back to happiness. I think two is you've got to make sure that whatever you're doing is a great product or service. It has to be really great. And I go back to what I was saying earlier, where if you're a new company, I mean, unless it's like some new industry or new market if it's an untapped market, then you have more ability to, the standard is lower for your product or service. But if you're entering anything where there's an existing marketplace against large entrenched competitors, then your product or service needs to be much better than theirs. It can't be a little bit better, because then you put yourself in the shoes of the consumer and they say, why would you buy it as a consumer? You're always going to buy the trusted brand unless there's a big difference. So a lot of times, entrepreneur will come up with something which is only slightly better. And it can't just be slightly better. It's got to be a lot better.
You know, this is an interesting time. I'm watching a clip of the richest man in the world, or maybe he might be number two, I don't know, giving his thoughts, his advice to people like myself on if you want to build a business and you want to be successful. When I tell y'all about studying the game, when y'all ask me to be your mentor, and I always tell you no, this is why. You got people who are way more successful than me, who have been through way more than I have, who are giving you gems like this. Listen to what Elon Musk said, but I'm also going to give you three things that I've learned if you want to be a successful entrepreneur, at least get to where I'm at, if not, go past me. If you somebody want to know them three things, watch this entire clip. But before you do that, hit like, hit share, hit comment, click that TubeBuddy link in the description box. It's gonna change your life. I can't guarantee that, but it might. I hope so.
My ducks, my swans, welcome to the pond.
My name is Dorian from Group82Music.com, and right here, we got Elon Musk giving advice to entrepreneurs who want to be successful. For those of y'all don't know who Elon Musk is, and I know a lot of y'all think, who doesn't know who Elon Musk is? Well, some people don't know. You can't be a butthole. See, I'm trying to get better with the language. I need y'all to show me appreciation for that. Elon Musk, one of the richest men, if not the richest man in the world. He's originally from South Africa. He moved to California, went to Stanford, started a couple businesses, became a part of the PayPal Mafia. You don't know who the PayPal Mafia is, go look up the PayPal Mafia. Had SpaceX, and he's the owner of Tesla. So this man knows a lot about having a successful business. And a lot of gems he gave right here is spot on. But I'm gonna give you the three things that I've been through as an entrepreneur for any of you who are looking to start a podcast or start a food truck or just want to grow your social media. These three things I'm about to tell you, please pay attention to, because I wish people would have said this to me before I started my entrepreneurial journey. The first thing you gotta have if you want to be an entrepreneur is mental toughness. If you aren't mentally tough, this thing's gonna crush you. It's gonna crush you really, really fast. And it's not the mental toughness from what the outsiders are saying. You gotta have that. It's the mental toughness from yourself. The self-doubt, the insecurity, the imposter syndrome, thinking you lack the creativity. Do you wanna have the responsibility and the accountability of people working up under you? And you gotta have serious mental toughness. You had to have been through something in your life. And I ain't saying you gotta be from the hood. I ain't saying you gotta be in some, Lifetime movie fucked up situation, but you do have had to been through. What the fuck am I talking about? You do have had to been through some sort of adversity in order to be a great entrepreneur. Whether it was sports, whether it was law school, I don't know. But if you have never been through something where you push yourself to the limits for years on end, this is not for you. It ain't even gonna be enjoyable for you. The only reason you enjoy mental toughness challenges is because you've been through them before. before, and you know that the end felt really good. Like for me, I didn't play basketball in high school. I got cut. I couldn't get involved with basketball, but I made myself a viable candidate for Division I college basketball coaching position. So I took on little small jobs here and there and worked these camps and worked these combines, all these things I talked about in my CJ McCollum video. Let's put that up right here. Tell you my whole basketball story. So when I actually became a Division I coach at Jacksonville University, director of basketball operations, I knew I had accomplished something. There were a lot of people who had played or had coached at smaller levels, and now I was ahead of them because I put in the work. I moved 12 times in my 20s. So the mental toughness aspect is something that I had been through. I knew who I was. I knew I was battle tested for somebody else's business or something I didn't own. So when it came to my business, what I did own, I knew I'd be able to ride it out. The second thing, if you want to be a successful entrepreneur, is you got to be okay with being alone. I was by myself a lot. So I had a sister, had a great relationship with my sister, but most of the time I was an only child. It's like I was a part-time sibling, you know, majority of the time, I guess not full-time. I got used to being by myself. I got used to thinking out loud to myself. I got used to just being in silence. I got used to coming up with plans by myself and executing, and it made me okay with being alone. So going back to what I was saying about basketball, I moved all those times in my 20s. I took these jobs, these remote locations like Banner Elk, North Carolina. I was okay being alone. So when it came time for me to be an entrepreneur, this was nothing. I'd already been here. I'd already been by myself. So, you know, people looking to me for answers, I had to come up with answers all the time. People looking to me to lead them somewhere, I had to lead myself places all the time. Sometimes people follow, sometimes they didn't. So I've always been okay being myself and who I am. And if you ain't got that, I don't know how you're going to be an entrepreneur. Maybe if you are involved in some sort of collective or you got business partners, but if you are a solo entrepreneur, you 100% got to be okay being by yourself. And finally, the third thing, if you want to be a successful entrepreneur that you got to have emotional stability. If you are a person who gets easily wavered when things go high and you go off this hypothetical tangent of what success is going to be, this is not for you, because you will be humbled very, very quickly and you'll be brought back down. If you can't handle coming down, you're gonna crash. This ain't for you. Because when you're an entrepreneur, something goes wrong every damn day. Every single day, something goes wrong. Whether it's a meeting, whether it's a phone call, something. Every day, something goes wrong. And that is what you're doing all day, is fixing problems and putting out fires while simultaneously looking for new offensive opportunities for your business to generate new revenue. It takes a very, very mentally tough person who's okay with their own thoughts and has emotional stability to be able to handle that. And people need to be honest with themselves before they take this entrepreneurial journey. But you have to be real if you can handle this. I firmly believe in the next 24 to 36 months, so by 2024, there's going to be an all-out war on entrepreneurs. People are going to look at entrepreneurs as the enemy, because so many people are trying to be entrepreneurs right now and are going to fail because they lack these three things I listed in this video. If you're a person that starts a business and it doesn't work out for you, don't use that as a reason to hate all entrepreneurs. Just realize this wasn't for you. I ain't trying to tell nobody don't go after their dreams, but I would say you need to train yourself and get those three skills first before you start putting your time and money and all your resources, including your relationships, into something that you might not be prepared for. If you're somebody that thinks you're really prepared for this, whether it's the music business or whatever your entrepreneurial endeavor is, if you're on Instagram, click that link up top. You're on YouTube, click the link in the box. Click them two buddy links too. I'm out the pod. Y'all stay true.
Group82University.com.